Finally, tonight's 2017 Helms Legacy Award honoree has transformed a possible lifetime jail sentence into a lifelong service to others. Meet Anthony.
I'm here to introduce Anthony Martinez as our Helms Award winner for this year. He had only been out of prison for 3 days when he came to me and was looking for a second chance, and that's part of what Goodwill is all about, giving people second chances.
I threw so many challenges at Anthony during his training. He stepped up to the plate every time. Anthony's story is powerful because of where he's come from, but also to where he wants to go.
I'd just like to congratulate Anthony. He's very deserving of the Helms Legacy Award.
So my duties at the West Retail Center include day-to-day operations, getting clothes in and out, making store that look good. I never thought that I would be in a position where I had so much responsibility. I was adopted at an early age. I do feel blessed that I was adopted into a good family, but there always has been a void that I carried from a young age, feeling that whoever my real family was, that I wasn't good enough for them. My dad was big into sports, so I was big into sports. I loved baseball. My dad was in the Air Force. We traveled around. I've been all over the world. And when my dad retired and we landed here in Colorado Springs, 3 or 4 years after that, my parents divorced. My mom said, if your dad's such a great guy, then why don't you go live with him? And kicked me out the house. And I was doing drugs. I dropped out of school. I went to live with a friend. I started selling and dealing. I would binge drink with cocaine, sniff heroin. I started to get into armed robbery. What I would do is go around and rob all the drug dealers I could with my friends, and then turn around and put a mask on and rob my friends. I went to a jail at that time. I called my dad to bond me out, and he bonded me out. And I told him I was gonna make a change, and it just got worse. I ended up getting caught with 10 or 15 plants, I remember, and they hit me with a cultivation charge. And I got out and I told my dad, like, hey man, this time it's serious. I'm changing. Now I'm not doing that stuff no more. A month and a half later, the string of armed robberies landed me in a predicament that this time I wasn't going to be able to escape from.
I was working for the police department as a 911 operator, and I saw the call on the screen, and I saw the name. So I ran over to the dispatcher, and I go, that's my son. And she goes, he just got caught for armed robbery.
I remember thinking that it didn't matter, because as soon as I got to prison, I was just gonna overdose on heroin. I had 23 felonies. The deal on the table was 96 years. My lawyer came back and said, I have a 20-year deal for you if you sign it right now. And if you don't, I promise you, you're never getting out. And so I did, I signed it right then. I don't cry. I cried then. People always ask me, when did I decide to make a change? And believe it or not, I actually decided to make that change when my dad came to visit me.
Leaving my son in jail was hard. All you want to do is just grab him and take him with you. And I would cry. Every time.
And it was then where I started reading everything that I could possibly read. The books gave me a vision on what I could potentially build with life. And they also put a light onto a lot of the victim mentality thinking that I had. I blamed a lot of people for what I did, particularly my family. I realized that I'm the only one that chose to go through with any of the decisions that I made. And once I realized that, I started placing special emphasis on the choices that I would make. Instead of just walking away from my gang, I really decided that what I wanted to do was help people come out of that type of condition. I was released from prison in June 2014.
I was looking online as we're trying to find any kind of organization that would hire a felon, and there's far and few between. And once he got on with Goodwill, I go, great.
As I moved up to shift supervisor, direct report of the front end, and then applied for the MIT program, I got a random call. It was my parole officer telling me that effective immediately that I had been discharged of my complete sentence. And what I did was call all of the people of Discover Goodwill that invested in me, that made this moment a reality. And I thank them for believing in me and for giving me an opportunity to prove myself. And I also thank them for the call that I was about to make to my dad. And I said, hey dad, guess what? And he was like, what? And I was like, I'm off parole, man. To me, that was probably one of the biggest moments in my life, was being able to finally, for the first time, hold up my end of the bargain and something. Goodwill has saved my most prized relationship in my life, which is the relationship with my dad. It saved me from giving up. That thank you doesn't cut it. So with that, I feel that it's my responsibility to be the best that I can be every single day. It's more than me just being, hey, I'm happy, thank you. It's my life, man, has been saved.
Please welcome Discover Goodwill's 2017 Helms Legacy Award honoree, Anthony Martinez. So I guess real quick, what I want to say is that normally when people find out that I spent over a decade in prison, I get asked two questions. One of them is, what was it like in there? And the other one is, what's the biggest lesson that I've taken away from that experience? Tonight, for a few minutes, I want to talk about what the biggest lesson is that I've took away from the experience of losing a third of my life. And really what it is the value of time, because time is the biggest asset that any of us have. And so it would be a privilege of mine for someone like me who has wasted and thrown away so much of his time through carelessness and immaturity to take the time right now and the few minutes that I have to honor the people that have allowed me to become really who I am today and the very reason why I'm on this stage. With that being said, number one, I gotta thank God. I think that just kind of goes without saying, and miraculous things have happened for me, so I'm happy. And hey, Dad, hey, I love you, man. T- to my beautiful girlfriend, Antoinette, that's here tonight, I know it was hard telling your parents you fell in love with an ex-con that had a part-time job. But you know what, babe? Like, I love you so much for believing in me when I told you that, hey, if you stick by me, like, I'm never giving up. I'm going to keep pushing forward. And also to her parents, Mr. and Mrs. Moses that are here in the audience tonight, you've embraced me as your own family. Words can't express how grateful I am for that. To my best friend Storm that's here, hey brother, we've been through some dark times, man. How crazy is it that we're here right now? And I want to thank some people that I've had the privilege of working with that have absolutely, in every way possible, changed my life for the better. First and foremost, I want to thank Rob Prather for giving me the chance. I know I showed up at the interview with clothes that didn't fit, and I probably wasn't matching. Something that wouldn't happen today. Hey, I want to thank Brian Baker, district manager. Man, words can't express how much you mean to me, brother, wherever you're at. All the mentorship and everything like that. Lori Molly, such a special place in my heart. Sherry Richer, the director right now of operations. All these people are huge role models to me. Troy Smith, Roland Warren, Clara Vasquez, George Hammond. Man, you used to tie my tie when I first got promoted because I didn't know how to tie a tie. Appreciate you, man. Brian Smith, Grace Vigil, Harlan Hobson. Hey, brother, you taught me a lot about leadership, man. I appreciate that. Jason Work, you've really made me feel at home in my new capacity in within the organization, and words can't express how grateful I am for that. Angel Green, Angela Taylor. It's funny that I always used to look up to you, and I find out how much you looked up to me, and it would keep me pushing forward. Kevin Dillon came out here to support me tonight, man. I appreciate that. Rusty Sturgeon, great guy. Randy Lawler, quiet hero in my corner. Glenna Stanley, awesome person, inspired me from afar. Josh Garza, man, you came to training, man, and you were inspiring me. Katja Andrus, I know you're here tonight, and I know you came to support me. You have no idea how much that means to me. I also want to thank Tim Cooper. He's the current vice president of retail and ops. With the conversations that me and him have had, they've been few, but to be honest, I've taken some things to heart. And the truth is that I've never had a lot of people believe in me before. So for the group of people that I've had the privilege to work for that have believed in me, sometimes I think that it can't be true. Because everybody always used to tell me that there was no way I would ever amount to anything. And again, I just want to say, Dad, you had every right to give up on me, man, but you didn't. I'm glad you're here tonight, because I love you so much. And to the people, and this is something that was big on my heart tonight, to all the supporters of Goodwill, there's so many people here tonight that I don't know. I really wish that I could shake your hands and give you a hug tonight. And the reason why is because it hasn't started with me. You've been believing in people. I've just happened to cross this path, and I'm one of those people that have been able to benefit from your belief in people all along. So to all the people that support Goodwill, the champions of Discover Goodwill and everything like that, please know from the bottom of my heart that I truly feel that everybody in this room tonight
has played a special role in not changing my life. It's not changing my life. You all have literally played a part in saving my life, honestly. I can't stress that enough. So as I look throughout this room tonight, hey, you all played a part in saving this life right here, saving the relationship I had with my family, with my father, with my friends. You've given me self-worth. I mean, I don't know a lot of you, but I can tell you from the bottom of my heart that you all mean a lot to me, because I didn't think getting out of prison that I was going to have anybody that ever believed in me. I'm going to end tonight with a quote from a poet that I love, that I read a while ago, that I said I was going to embody that. And I'm sure a lot of us know of her, but her name is Maya Angelou. So, in closing tonight, on a lighter note, my mission in life is not merely to survive, but to thrive, and to do so with some passion, with some compassion, with some humor, and with some style. Thank you, everybody.